fellow Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. So today I'm going to show you something that you can do every day that is going to guaranteed help you improve your picking and your fretting, along with help you improve your stretch across the fretboard, which is really important because that'll give you a lot better control for reaching wider distances to play notes that are basically outside of that common four fret position. Now, what this exercise comes down to is it's all about planning a drill using scale tones that incorporates the sixth, fifth, and fourth string layout of a three note per string scale. And it also means practicing in a way that covers the entire neck. So what's really cool here is that the exercise itself is very easy to do. You can do it in literally probably a minute. And once you begin building the technique from the scale, you're gonna find that it generates a lot of control, not only for the stretch that you're gonna have across the neck, but you'll learn your scales better. You'll have better left and right hand control, and you'll understand your key signatures a lot better as you rotate through the different keys as you do this exercise. Now, let's jump into an explanation just before we get into doing the exercise, because I want you to fully understand how this exercise operates. Now, just before we get started on actually doing the study, I want to explain a few things here. And it has to do with how the exercise operates, how it's laid out, and how it's covering string positions and so forth. So our example is going to be using the notes of the key of G major. G major has one sharp, it's F sharp, and all the other notes are natural. And this means that our scale tones are going to operate out of that G major scale. So we're in the key of G. Now, the principle of how the exercise works is actually quite simple. What we're doing is we're focusing on the scale's naming note, which is of course G. That's going to be starting our run of scale tones off of the sixth string. So that's off the root of the scale. And then what we're going to do next is off of the fifth string, we're going to look for the scale's fifth tone. So G, A, B, C, D. D is the scale of G's fifth tone. So that's what we're going to use for building off of the fifth string. And then to complete the run of scale tones, what we're going to do is look at that last group of notes built off of the scale's fourth degree. So in the key of G is G, A, B, C. So it's a C note. And that is what we'll be using off of the fourth guitar string. So let's zoom in on the neck, and I'm going to demonstrate now exactly how this works. Starting in the key of G, remember the G is the root, so we're going to look at that off of the sixth string. Our G note that we're going to focus on will be on third fret, sixth string. And the first pattern layout goes like this. There's two whole steps on that sixth string, so frets 3, 5, and 7. And then we're going to go to the fifth string. We'll have two whole steps there. So again, 3, 5, and 7 are the frets. And then we're going to move to the fourth string, and we're going to have frets 4, 5, and 7. So a half step and a whole step. And then the same thing on the third string. So we have four guitar strings that we're covering there. And that's the layout. Right? So that's the first run of notes. Now remember, that was off the root of G, off the sixth string. And then when we go to the fifth of the key, which is a D, we're going to be on the fifth string. So fifth of the key, fifth string. It's really easy to remember. And then we're going to start on that fifth string, and we're going to have two whole steps there. Then we're going to, that's starting from fifth fret, so frets 5, 7, and 9. And then we're going to carry on to the fourth string, and we'll have frets 5, 7, and 9 again. So another couple of whole steps. Same thing on the third string, 5, 7, and 9, one more time, another couple of whole steps. And then we're going to jump up two positions here to the seventh position, and we'll have frets 7, 8, and 10. So frets 7, 8, and 10. So a half step and a whole step there. So now we've got, and you combine that run of notes with the lower run, and you'll have this. So it's pretty good workout even just doing that, and that's just the start of it. So, you know, we've done the root of the key, which is the G, and then we've had that on the sixth string for the root, and then when we go to the fifth of the key, the D, that's setting us up off of the fifth string for that layout. And I would start by just practicing both those layouts there. Watch that you don't get any hand pain, because, you know, doing large stretches like this, it can really put a lot of effort on the hand. And another thing to watch out for too is fingering. You know, if you're going with two whole steps, you're going to want to use index, middle, and small finger. Just gives you a better reach, and it feels more comfortable than using the ring finger. You can tell the gap now between the ring finger and the small finger. It's kind of a tight understanding there between the two appendages. So definitely go with index, middle, and small finger. So that's the first leg of the exercise. Well, I still have more to cover with you on this topic, but I just wanted to take a short break to let you know that if you need to learn more about the basics of, you know, keys and harmony, as well as the different bar chord shapes and other ideas, then I'm going to make you a great offer. With any donation over $5 or any purchase made from my Teespring store, I'll send you a free collection of some of my most popular digital handouts around here. One is called Harmonized Arpeggio Drills. This is a fantastic handout that's going to train you how to develop your diatonic arpeggios, plus it'll get you a little bit better with understanding key signatures. Another one that I want to send you is my bar chord and keys handout, which is really nice because if you need help on key signatures and if you want to learn a little bit more on how to apply bar chords on the neck, it's got a progression in there too that applies them, and it's really going to help you clarify how keys operate and how to get your chords functioning across the neck. Plus, I'm going to give you my notation pack. It's great. It's 8 pages of guitar worksheets for, you know, notating anything related to music charts, guitar chord diagrams, or if you have to use tab, it's all in there. There's lots of blank pages for understanding how to draw out all the stuff that you're working on guitar. Plus, on top of all that, I'm going to send you 5 bonus handouts as well. So a lot of stuff pertaining to ideas that relate to old YouTube videos that I've put up, but it's information that you're not going to get anywhere else. So they're unique handouts. Now, once you make your donation or you do the merchandise purchase off Teespring, just send me an email off the contact page at creativeguitarstudio.com and let me know that you made your purchase or that you did a donation, and I'm going to email you those digital handouts within 24 hours. All right, so now let's talk about the final run of notes. Now remember, we're in the key of G. The fourth note of the key of G is C. 1, 2, 3, 4, G, A, B, C. So the C note that we're gonna function off of will be up here on the fourth guitar string at the 10th fret. And the first setup of tones is gonna go from 10 to 12 to 14. So it's a double whole step. And then we're gonna move to the third string and we're gonna have frets 11, 12, and 14, which is gonna be a half step whole step. When we get to the second string, and again, it's going to be a half step whole step, so frets 12, 13, 15. And then on the top string, it's frets 12, 14, 15. So that's going to be a whole step and a half, like that. So that covers our final run of notes in the exercise. Now what you'll want to do is, when you put all three of them together, we're functioning around a triplet feel. So we're going 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a, and then you're continuing another measure of music, 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a, and then finally 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. So when you put a metronome on, just try and keep things really steady and really smooth. You know, there's no sense in going too fast too soon. And then of course, you know, when you're really good at going ascending, start working descending. You know, just go through it in sections, memorize it, understand what the pulse of it feels like and how it's all set up on the guitar fingerboard and how you can trace things with your fingers to get the best possible fingerings. You know, it'll be tough going backwards because after you finish that run, you're going to jump into the seventh position and you're doing a fourth finger, middle, and index. And you're having that shift that takes fourth, middle, and index again, but with the double whole steps. So it's kind of a tough move. So, you can tell, you know, when you're moving it down, it's a tough move when you're having those transitions, you know, at each point on the neck to make it clear. But you'll find, you know, it's equally as challenging when you first begin working on it as you make those transitions on the lower register too. You just have to work on it slowly and, you know, get all of the movements and the ways that your fingers are going to jump over to each new position. You'll have to get all of that clarified. And then over time, it'll feel smoother and smoother. You'll even find that in a practice period, when you first start, it'll be kind of sloppy, and then it'll get smoother and then smoother. And then you'll find that it kind of starts going into autopilot, and then everything starts feeling really comfortable. So it's a great exercise. There's lots of benefits that come from it. My parting words on the practice of it are never practice with any pain. If your hand starts to feel a little bit sore from the stretches and the large reach that we have with this exercise, take a break and then come back later and start working again, because the last thing in the world you want to do is play guitar with hand pain or hand stress, because it could turn into tendonitis. It's not a guarantee that it might, but you know, it's always a possibility. If you push yourself too hard to do these studies, you could get a bout of it, and it really is a terrible thing to go through. So watch that. Never play with pain. Keep that in mind. Otherwise, the exercise is really great on a lot of levels to help your technique. All right, so before we wrap up, let's just recap one more time exactly how this exercise works and how you can apply it throughout all the musical keys on a daily basis until you fully develop all of your skills with it, and then you can maybe redesign it or come up with a new exercise to replace it. I usually find that if I do new exercises every day for around 3 weeks or so, sometimes I gotta do them a little longer, maybe 4 weeks or 6 weeks. Generally, by about that time frame, I'm pretty much done with the exercise, and I can either redesign it or maybe move on to a brand new one. So you want to start by taking into consideration with this exercise here, you want to learn what the key is that you're going to go with, and then you want to understand the first and the fourth and the fifth scale degrees that are a part of the key that you have selected. Now, in our example, we started by using the key of G, and we took the G note, of course, as the first step. Then the D is the fifth step. The C was the scale's fourth step. And so now we had the layout and the understanding how it was sitting across the guitar. So you'll want to remember that the stepwise position of each tone represents the string that you're going to use as the pattern's layout's starting point. Now, in the key of G, the root note of G, remember, that was for our sixth string. And then the fifth tone of D was for the fifth string, and the fourth tone of the key, which was the C in that case, was located on the fourth string. It's really easy to remember this. It works really fantastic, and the patterns that I gave you, they can be used for any key. Now, just so you fully understand this, let's also go and maybe switch keys to the key of C and just do this key really quickly here so you really comprehend how it operates. Now, in the key of C, the root of C would obviously operate as the sixth string because it's the root of the scale. The key's fifth of G would operate off of the fifth guitar string, and then the key of C has an F as its fourth, so that means the F note would operate off of the fourth guitar string. So once you do this for a few days with a bunch of different keys, you're going to get the hang of it, and it's going to become really easy to do. Well, guys, if you want to get a more detailed breakdown of all this information, including diagrams and the tab for each idea I went over, then head down to my blogger page at creativeguitarstudio.blogspot.com. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and thumbs up below. Also, remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you'll want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.